There are 7 things that you're doing as a logo designer that you need to stop doing. You may not be doing all of these, but I guarantee you, you're doing at least one of these things. So today's video is about how you can present your logo designs better and get more of them approved, because these things are gonna be costing you money. And that's what I'm here to do, is help you not just make more money, but improve your processes. So today's video is about how you can present your logos and the 7 things that you need to stop doing. And we're gonna talk about how you can fix them too. So the first don't is emailing the logo to your client to present it. That is not how you present a logo correctly. The best way you can do that is by either doing it in person or doing it through something like Zoom or some sort of video sharing like Google Meet, and actually presenting it with them one-on-one. Set an appointment for a half an hour to walk them through the process of how you actually created that logo. This is a really big deal. You want to present it on Zoom. That's the first one. The second don't, and it's associated with the email, is don't just send attachments, whether it's through a Facebook Messenger or through some other form of communication like text messaging. You actually need to make a presentation deck, whether that's in Google Slides or PowerPoint or Adobe Spark. You need to actually make a presentation and present the logo in detail of the different concepts that you're offering, the fonts that you're using, and why. This is an opportunity to really craft something and build a lot of value in your logo presentation. So do not just send attachments or screenshots over to your customers. I've done this on occasion, just when I know for sure that I have a really amazing rapport, like an existing client I've already been working with for years, and they asked me and we did a bunch of concepts already, and I know I nailed it. Then I'll send them a text message and say, hey, what do you think about this? And if they love it, then great. But for the general rule, you should be actually presenting these on a presentation deck, like in Google Slides. The third don't is sending over the logo files and sending over the logos in general with a bunch of different effects and colors and styling and stylizing. Don't do drop shadows and bevels and embosses and strokes and gradients and all the other things. You need to keep the logo black and white. That is the way to do it, because if you can get a concept that they love that's in black and white, and this is part of explaining it to them, is if they love it in black and white, then when you add all those fancy things like the mock-ups and the colors and the gradients and the shadows and all that fancy stuff, they're gonna really love it. But you need to make sure that they love that concept right from the beginning with the black and white concepts. Keep it very simple, keep it straight to the point, and get the actual idea around the concept itself and not about the colors and all the other stylizing. You wanna just keep it simple. The fourth don't is sending an even number of concepts. I see a lot of people do this. They send 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 concepts to a customer. I've always done odd numbers because you're able to eliminate one pretty quickly usually when you just have 3. One of them immediately goes out and now you're only picking between A and B. I probably sell more logo concepts in 3 packages, the 3 concept package, than 5 or 7. 5 is great as well, but you're able to easily eliminate 1 or 2 right off the bat and you're still left with an odd number. So this is a really important thing that I do in all of my presentations, is make sure I supply 3, 5, or 7 concepts. This is something that you should do as well. The fifth don't, and it goes along with the concepts, is sending too many concepts. The customer does not need 8, 10, 12, 15, 18 concepts. Don't overwhelm them with the amount of ideas and decisions to make. You're the expert. You need to narrow it down for them. You can create 12, 13, 14, 15 concepts, but you need to narrow it down to the best 3, 5, or 7 concepts. This is a really important piece of what we do as well, as we come together as a team. We bounce the ideas off of people in our network, people who are really relevant to the type of client that we're working with, and we get that feedback and we narrow it down as much as we possibly can. I don't ever sell anything more than 7 concepts. There's no need for it, and you don't need to do that either. The sixth don't is actually making mock-ups and business cards and social graphics before you've even finalized the logo. Some people like to put this in their presentations and they add all these extra things, the colors, the bevels, the business cards, the vehicle graphics. They spend all this time when the concept of the logo itself hasn't even been finalized. So you need to make sure that you keep it simple, do just the logo concepts, get approval on that, and then you can move on to those next phases. You don't need to mock up the logo. The logo mock-up comes at the very end, once they've approved the colors, all those things are really important. You wanna make sure that you focus their energy on just approving the main concept, then you move them on to the colors and getting the colors that you're gonna use based on the information that you collected, and then adding those colors in there and then getting approvals on that. And then you can start to actually create a logo mockup that they can use on social media or you can use on your portfolio. A lot of people are jumping way down the road too early, and I don't want you to do that. So make sure that you don't spend too much time focusing on stuff until you have that approval. Getting the approval and getting the client to approve of that logo is the most important piece. The seventh don't is leaving it all up to them. You create the concept, then you just send it over to them, you email it, or you do whatever you're doing, and hopefully you're not, but you put it on a pitch deck, right? You put it on a pitch deck, and now you're just like, all right, just pick one. Well, part of the presentation process is telling them the origin story of why you picked this font, why you picked this style, how you came up with the design concepts, why you feel it fits their brand, and tying it back to the discovery session that you did at the very beginning. If they know that this actually relates to exactly what you told them, now they're gonna have an affinity for it. But if there's no context, they have no information, they don't understand why these concepts were created or how they were created or what was the idea behind it, they don't see any of the drawings, and you don't really show any of the origin of it, you just show them a finished concept, they're not gonna love it. They're not gonna have any attachment or any idea or history behind it. A lot of the logos that we see that we love nowadays have become popular because they have a lot of hidden messages or certain things about them that give them that origin story. They either evolved and changed into something, they have a smile, something unique and creative. So you don't wanna miss that piece of your presentation. This is an important piece that I do in every single presentation that I do, is I walk them through and I lead the client. That is the right way to present a logo, is you wanna lead them to what is the outcome that you are hoping that they pick. Which concept is it that you recommend for them? They may go a different direction, but if you give your strong recommendation, they go a different direction, you're still serving the customer. You should lead them and tell them your professional recommendation of what you think the best logo concept is for them, and they should value that. They should trust you, and they should want to be a part of that. So those are the seven don'ts, and I answered how you should do it. So hopefully that really helps you guys out and gives you some clear direction on presenting a logo. I want to see you guys win, and we're going to be talking more about this in the Facebook group in the coming weeks. So make sure you check out Instagraphics Pro Network on Facebook, and I look forward to seeing you guys in there. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Adrian Boisel, and as always, keep looking up.